Hello and welcome back for part 3 of this review of the MV-22 Osprey from Miltech Simulations. We're going to be looking at emergency procedures, what's likely to go wrong, and what you can do about it. I'm going to be covering vortex ring state, single engine failure, double engine failure, and asking the question, will it autorotate? First up, vortex ring state. Now you may be asking yourself, what is vortex ring state? This is an Osprey hovering, pulling in air from above and pushing it down with a lot of force, creating lift and a lot of disturbed air. But if the Osprey descends too quickly, it can fall into its own wash. This causes the rotors to re-ingest the disturbed air, creating a vortex and neutralizing the lift generated. It's like trying to swim against the current. No matter how hard you try, the result is inevitable. And this is how it looks when you're flying the Osprey. Keep an eye on my vertical speed on the right, as well as the throttle on the top left. Notice how when the Osprey starts to drop, even at full power, I can't get any lift. So how do you get out of it? When you're rotating in a vortex, you can't lift out of it, but you can fly out of it. If you tilt yourselves forwards and push the throttle, you should be able to move out of the disturbed air and gain some airspeed to stabilise your lift. Like swimming across the current rather than against it. Which in the flight sim looks like this.
Sink rate.
It's not quite as exciting, but it'll save you having to restart the flight. Here our Osprey is happily cruising along in aeroplane mode, enjoying the scenery. Then, suddenly, without warning, an engine fails. But our pilot isn't too concerned. You may think the loss of a single engine will cause the Osprey to tilt over to one side. But due to where the gearbox is designed, one engine will quite happily run both props equally. You will of course lose some power and speed, but you're not about to drop out of the sky. However, it is advisable to find somewhere to land safely. In this case, I'm reversing course to go back to the airfield I just took off from. Now if you want to err on the side of caution, you could do a rolling landing. This will put less strain on your one remaining engine and is probably the safer choice. However, you might be coming back to a carrier or a helipad, and rolling landing may not be an option. But not to worry, the Osprey is perfectly capable of doing a vertical landing with just one engine. So the loss of a single engine isn't a major concern, but what if we lost both engines? That's where things start to get interesting.
Defying interesting.
Oh God, we're all gonna die?
There goes engine one, and there's engine two. No engines means no generators and no hydraulics. Time is of the essence, and the first thing you need to do is get the APU set to emergency run. While the APU warms up, you can pick where you're going to land. And, as luck would have it, there happens to be a road beneath us. Having taken care of the essentials, it's time to let the crew know what's going on.
This is the captain. We have a little problem with our entry sequence, so we may experience some slight turbulence and then explode.
Now the crew is at ease and we have some hydraulic pressure back, it's time to put down the landing gear. You'll need to trade altitude for airspeed in order to avoid a wing stall. Remember, the Osprey only has little wings, so you'll need more airspeed than normal to maintain lift. When you get to about 200 feet above the ground, start to rotate the nacelles upwards. This will slow you down as you come into land, and should also save the props from striking the ground. But remember, your priority is getting safely on the ground. Saving the props is secondary. Give a small flare just before you touch down, and get ready on the rudder pedals. Then, once on the ground, apply the brakes as you would do for a normal landing.
Another happy landing.
As you can see, the aircraft is in one piece and the rotors are intact. And just to prove it's undamaged, we can restart the engines and take off again. And with the engine running, we no longer need the APU. If, however, you do strike the props, then you won't be able to start the engine. You'll hear the turbine start to spin up, but the props won't rotate. Fortunately, this simulation has a button for that. If you watched the first video, you know that the CDU has an option to reset fails. If you missed that video, there's a link at the end of this one. Once you press this magic button, you'll find that your engines start again with no problem at all. I can't say for certain, but I'm fairly sure this option isn't available in the real aircraft. Now for the big question, will the Osprey auto-rotate? We're currently in hover mode and I'm going to switch off the engines as before. And now I pitch forward to try and gain some airspeed. But the only airspeed I'm gaining is straight downwards. To try and explain why this happens, I'm going to shut down the engines of the Osprey and a Cadbury G2 helicopter on the runway at the same time. Watch how long it takes the rotors on the Osprey to stop compared to the rotors on the helicopter. You can already see the Osprey rotor starting to slow down. The problem is the rotors on the Osprey are a lot smaller than those on a normal helicopter, which means they simply can't hold the inertial energy. When in flight, the force exerted on the rotors by the aircraft dropping through the air causes them to slow down much faster. This is why the Osprey is unable to auto-rotate, and it's one of its biggest safety concerns. And for that very reason, the President of the United States is not actually allowed to fly on one. However, the chances of both engines failing are quite slim, and as it's just a simulation, you can always just restart. And at just over a minute, the Osprey's rotors have nearly stopped, whereas the helicopter is still going. If you've enjoyed this video and would like to see some more of my reviews, please go ahead and hit subscribe, and why not hit like while you're at it. And if you want to see my other videos on the Osprey, you can find them here. For now though, thanks for watching and fly safe.